Hi everyone, welcome back to raigurukul.com. I am Deepak Rai. In today's video, we are going to embark on a fun coding journey. We will learn how to build straightforward search application using Python Twikinter library. By the end of this tutorial, we will have function search interface that allows you to find items within a predefined list. Let's jump right in. Before we dive into the code, let's talk about what we're building today. We're creating a search application using Python Twikinter library that lets you search for items within a predefined template. So here we are just running this to showcase the result. So whenever you run this code, you'll find it out. This UI will be available. Here we have to enter search query and click on search, and if search is available, that name will be populated. And if the predefined list data is not available, then we will get no result form. This can serve as a foundation for more complex search functionality in your projects. Ensure that we have a Python installed to start with this coding. We'll also need Twikinter library, which is usually included within the Python packages. But if you don't have, you can install it just adding pip install tkey as from the command prompt. And after that, we will import this library. So for importing the library Twikinter as tkey and from Twikinter import tkey, these two imports will be most required for performing this actions. If you have not installed and you have not imported, then you won't be able to use their related attributes. That's the reason it's mandatory required to be installed. Here we have created def or functions perform search, and the query we have defined search query equal to entry.get. So whichever value we have in entry, that we are calling it out. If search query is matching with the results, first delete the value whichever is available in the container, and then if item is found, then we will display the exactly same item name. Else search result insert no result found, that text should be available. So here this will go into the program from the search list and compare the value which we have entered into text box. Then if there is a value exists, then exactly same name will be populated. And if the value is not matching, we will showcase no result found. This is exactly same like pharmaceutical industry, where user wanted to search some medicine is available in their stock or not. If the medicine is available, it will say yes, we have this medicine and the description about it. But if you don't have this medicine available, no medicine exists or stock is empty, we can populate this type of message. So generally, this is a piece where we are performing the search from existing data. Now, next category, we are creating main Twikinter video window. So root equal to tk.tk is helping us to create this window, and we are providing the title. So title we wanted to give as a simple search app. Let me explain you with this code. And here you can see this is the title. Here we have added same text. So normally the task of adding the title is root.title, and finally we are providing the text of title. Next options, create and pack widgets. Normally search labels is helping us to add the label to enter a search query. So to add the label, normally we are using label as a name, and this label name we have defined as tk.label and then value into search query as the value, and we are adding or as a part of pack, and the pad y is the spacing between text and this text box. So this is helping us to add the proper spacing between two attributes. So this will add space between this label and text box. Next is search entry is equal to tk.entry and root and width is 40. This is the entry tab or the container. Sorry, this is the entry tab or container where we have defined pad by equal to 5. Next, width is we are adding 40 and pad by equal to 5. So this spacing between button and this is having 5 pixels. And next, I wanted to add a search button. The text would be search. To add this text, we are using root as a window because this is a main window we are targeting to add this button. And for adding this, we are using tk.button as a method. And within this method, we are defining the parameters. So root as a window, we have added here. Text equal to search, it means its value. And finally, command perform search. So whenever the user will click, the perform search action will be called or event will be called. And this event will be packed in the pack pad Y. Again, the spacing of 10. Next, search results. That search results should be added into dot text. Again, we are using same window and wrapping at tk.word. Height and width, we are providing height as 10 and width as 40. So we are talking about this height. Height as 10 and width as 40. And finally, the search results will be packed again with padx and pady. Padx is 10 and pady is 5. Here we have added list item and these are the list value. Let's see, I am performing the search of banana and clicking on search. If this value is exist, I am getting the same result. Let's see, I am searching for guava. And if I will click on this, no result is found. Let me add this value into, instead of strawberry, we'll add here. Let me see if this result is populated. No, because we have not added or run this code after adding this. So here we'll add and run the code again, paste the value, and now you'll see exactly same result is available here. So in the similar way, we can search for any value. If this value is accessed, then only we'll get a result. Otherwise, we don't have this value exist options or no result found. Text, that text can be modified at any point of time. It's totally up to us. And finally, I'm adding root.main loop to perform event loop. And this is the responsive loop which we are using for calling this actions. Now, let's summarize this. We have started with the installation of installation of Python as well as Twikinto library. And finally, we are importing this library. If we not import this library, we won't be able to use their attributes. After that, we have defined perform search and this search functions will have if and else conditions. If the value is found, then we are populating the same value into the container. And if the value is not found, then we are populating no result found. And the logic of this is built here, where we are creating the window and this window will have all those options like label, text, values, button, text box, everything is available here. And within that, we are adding spacing, that is padx and pady, and packing. It means we are securing the applications. And finally, here we have defined source results. This is our database, I can see, and within this value, if the value is fine, then we are populating as the same value. Otherwise, if there's no data, we are saying here we don't have the data exist. So this is how we have successfully built a simple search application using Python and Quickinto, we can build upon this foundations to create more advanced search functionalities in your projects. If you found this tutorial helpful, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more coding tutorials and tech related content. Feel free to leave your questions or suggestions in the comment sections below. And if you need this code in your email box or you want this into GitHub, send me in the comment section so that I can share with you the link. Happy coding, and I will catch you in the next video. Thank you for watching.